Ahoy, shipmates. Today we have the Queen Victoria returning to the port of Southampton. It's a lovely day with the strong April sun. Unfortunately, there's also some strong April winds, which is making it a little unpleasant. Queen Victoria is a Vista-class cruise ship operated by the Cunard Line and is named after the British monarch Queen Victoria. It is the same basic design as other Vista cruise ships, including the Queen Elizabeth. At 90,000 gross tons, it is the smallest of Cunard ships in operation. Its facilities include 7 restaurants, 13 bars, 3 swimming pools, a ballroom, and a theatre. Currently registered in Hamilton, Bermuda. Construction was started in May 2006 and launched in 15th of January 2007. The gross tonnage is 90,049 tons, 294 metres long and 32.3 metres wide. Decks in total, 12 of them passenger decks. Propulsion is delivered by 2 ABP Azipods, and they are 2 times 16.7 megawatts each. This gives the ship a top speed of 23.7 knots, 27.3 miles per hour, or for you metric types, 44 kilometers an hour. And the typical cruising speed is 18 knots, 21 miles an hour, or 33 kilometers an hour. Capacity of 2,081 passengers and a crew of 900. Unlike many of the previous Cunard ships, Queen Victoria is not a traditional ocean liner, as she does not have the heavy plating throughout the hull. However, the bow was constructed with heavier plating to cope with the transatlantic run. Queen Mary II cost approximately $300,000 per berth, nearly double that of many contemporary cruise ships. So Cunard made the economical decision to base the Queen Victoria on a modified Vista class cruise ship, and Queen Elizabeth retains the same design with some minor changes. Nonetheless, Ian McNaught, who was the Queen Victoria's captain in 2009, has asserted that the ship is a liner based on her classic decor. The ship was named after the British Queen Victoria, who reigned from 1837 to 1901. This makes her the first Cunard ship to be named for a Queen Regent, rather than a Queen Consort. A Queen Regent is a reigning Queen, whereas a Queen Consort is one that's merely Queen by association, as in married to the reigning King. Some elements of her interior decoration are loosely based on Victorian era design styles. Originally designed to be an addition to the Holland America fleet line, the order for a Vista class vessel put into Finsatterie was soon transferred by Cargo Corporation. To Cunard, with the intent that the vessel would become the MS Queen Victoria. The keel was laid down on the 12th of May 2006. 80 prefabricated steel blocks, each complete with interior structure, cabling and ducts, each weighing 325 tons, were added. The completed hull with superstructure was floated out on the 15th of January 2007 after having a bottle of Prosecco smashed against her side by Maureen Ryan, a Cunard employee who has served on all four Cunard Queens. The ceremony also saw the traditional placing of coins on the mast. In this case, a euro and a gold Queen Victoria sovereign were wielded beneath the radar mast. Queen Victoria departed the port of Venice on the 24th of August 2007 to commence her sea trials, and after handover to Cunard, arrived in Southampton to a fanfare of media attention on the 7th of December. Much of the coverage being focused on the ship's superlatives and representing Queen Victoria as Cunard's most luxurious ship. The same day, the ship was officially named by Camilla, the Duchess of Cornwall, continuing the tradition of Cunard Queens being named by royalty. The bottle of champagne did not break upon impact with Queen Victoria's hull, which according to nautical superstition is a bad omen. However, a backup bottle was immediately successful. Victoria's exterior design closely resembles that of Vista-class ships built for various cruise companies. A feature which distinguishes her from her younger fleet mate, Queen Elizabeth, is the more angled sloping stern as compared to the newer ship's vertical one. In addition to this, she lacks the covered games deck above the bridge, a feature which is present on the Elizabeth. During her 2017 refit, Queen Victoria was fitted with an additional block of cabins at the stern that makes her more similar appearance to Queen Elizabeth. The addition also made more space available and a newly redesigned aft Lido pool area and reduced the size of aft-facing balconies. Fortunately, it's a little difficult to see the aft of the ship today. Turning away from us. The Svitzer Bargate tug is gently pulling on the bows. And the pod drives in the rear of the ship, the spinning stern to shore. If I go over here and show you what dock the Queen Victoria is aiming for, I think you'll see what's happening. The city cruise terminal. Qu- Queen Victoria's puppet rooms are mainly located on the lower level public decks of the ships. Two deck and three deck. Unlike Queen Mary II, however, there is no central circulation access, the main corridors being to the port side. The ship does have the similar grand lobby staircase with an artwork feature as on Queen Mary ships. A relief portrait of the ship, situated on the main staircase, sculpted by British sculptor John McKenna. One deck, the lowest passenger deck, holds the most level of three-story stairwell lobbies, as well as the Royal Court Theatre. On two deck can be found the mid-level of the Royal Court Theatre, Casino, Golden Lion Pub, Queen's Room, Fondre a la Carte Restaurant, Charts Room Bar, and the lower level of both the Library and the Britannia Restaurant. The topmost level of the theatre, Royal Arcade, Midships Lounge, and upper level of the Library, formal dining room are on three deck, along with the wraparound exterior promenade. The decks above these mostly contain passenger cabins, until nine deck, on which are the Cunard Health Club and Spa, Winter Garden Lounge, Lido Restaurant, and two outdoor pools. On ten deck is the Commodore Club, Churchill Lounge for smokers, and Yacht Club, Night Club. The Queen's Grill and Princess Grill, with their attached lounge and an open courtyard between, are on 11 deck. Though Queen Victoria is theoretically a classless ship, it has been argued that Queen Mary II and Queen Elizabeth II, both of which followed the same practice of separating passengers into different restaurants based on the price of the cabin they booked, the Britannia as standard for regular cabins, the Princess Grill as the middle for those in junior suites, and the Queen's Grill as a superior for deluxe suite occupants, are usually ships divided into three classes, despite the fact that all of the public rooms are all used by passengers equally. Though the situation is similar on Queen Elizabeth II and Queen Mary II, it is further enhanced on Queen Victoria by the fact that the grill passengers, those dining in the Princess Grill and Queen's Grill, also have two private outdoor areas on 10 and 11 decks, with a specific name, Grills Terrace, a feature for which also appears on Queen Mary II at the aft section of 10 deck. Queen Victoria's Theatre is the first at sea to have private boxes. She also has a winter garden lounge with a retractable glass roof and a two-story library with a connecting spiral staircase. Along with the modifications to the stern of the ship in May 2017, the addition of extra cabins and the refurbishment of other dining facilities, the passenger capacity increased from 1,988 to 2,081. The Britannia Club restaurant was added, the chart room was updated, and the winter gardens were refreshed, along with the yacht club and new outdoor pool area. Queen Victoria can carry 3,000 tons of heavy fuel and 150 tons of marine gas oil, consuming 12 tons per hour at maximum output. Although the ship burns heavy fuel, it uses a slow sofa fuel in certain jurisdictions. The tug helping Queen Victoria dock today is the Svitzer Bargate. Svitzer is a global company based in Denmark. They specialise in harbour towage, a vital role in safety and reliability of port operations around the globe, operating in 100 ports worldwide. With crews familiar with local ports and expertise, allowing the supply chains and ensuring swift vessel handling. Svitzer also specialise in terminal towage. It serves some of the world's most prestigious oil and gas terminal projects, located in diverse range of environments across the globe, including Australia, Russia, Angola and Bangladesh. Svitzer has 180 years of towage experience. Annually undertaking more than 135,000 harbour towage jobs and over 50,000 LNG tanker assists every year. Employing 4,000 people in 34 countries. See here, the Svitzer Bargate tug is gently controlling the bow of the Queen Victoria while she comes alongside. Stiff breeze here today, which might be slowing down the docking. In the very background, you can see container ship that's currently unloading, the UASC Al Jasra. And immediately behind Queen Victoria, is the cruise ship Ventura. That'll probably come more into view later. Queen Victoria is currently empty with no passengers on board due to the coronavirus pandemic. You can see a shot of bow thruster to move the bows across. Cruise ship operations have been halted, and the expected resumption is the middle of May. It would seem to me that the operators have been carrying out repairs and maintenance works. Sea trawling them afterwards and going back into port. Svitzer Bargate tug was built in 2014. It has a gross tonnage of 231 tons. Svitzer have a reputation for naming their tugs after local landmarks. And you should be able to see now the Venturi cruise ship just behind the Queen Victoria. Said earlier, Svitzer Bargate is the tug assisting the Queen Victoria, and the Svitzer company has a habit of using local place names. And you may be wondering, what is the Bargate? Well, the Bargate is a medieval gate to the ancient medieval walled city of Southampton. This is the Bargate in a more festive colour scheme. It was built approximately 1180 and was constructed of stone and flint. Alterations were made to the building around 1920 when large drum towers were added to the north side and narrow slit windows. A two-story extension was made to the south side of the tower at the end of the 13th century, with four windows lighting up upstairs rooms. Work was also carried out to the interior of the upper room during the 13th century, with stone fireplaces were installed. An embattled north front was added to the building around 1400. A survey of the town's guns in 1468 reported that the Bargate held two breech loader guns and brass muzzle loaders. It is not clear when the Bargate started being used as a prison, but the first records of it date from 1439. In 1458, the prison was used to detain the Genesee population of the town as part of the response to the Genesee attack on the English trading expedition. At some point in the 16th century, the court fleet of Southampton started to meet at the Bargate, although it continued to switch between the Bargate and the Cawthorn Mound on Southampton Common until 1670. Also around the 16th century, it is thought that the wooden sculptures of lions were added in the front of the Bargate. And more historically relevant for us today, in 1605, the city's curfew and alarm bell was added to the southwest corner of the building. In the middle of the four windows is a statue of George III in Roman dress, which in 1809 replaced a wooden statue of Queen Anne. In 1899, the increase in road traffic and the introduction of trams led to proposals for the Bargate's demolition. It was reprieved at the subsequent council meeting, but the issue again rose in 1914 and 1923. The Bargate was, however, eventually separated from the adjoining town walls in the 1930s, using a scheme previously suggested in 1900. The first separation was made on the east side in 1932, with the second west side carried out in 1937. This is around the time that Portland cement was used in the works on the Bargate. This was later to cause problems as it trapped in water and within the structure, damaging the stones. The Bargate ceased being used as a court in 1933. And the court functions moving to law courts in the new Southampton Civic Centre. The monument again served as police headquarters for the city during the Second World War. In 1951, a museum of local history was opened in the Bargate as part of the celebrations to mark the Festival of Britain. The museum later closed. Between 2006 and 2012, following refurbishment funded by the South East England Development Agency, The upper room served as the Bargate Monument Gallery, during which time 42 exhibitions featuring the work of over 250 artists were staged here. In 2016, the Portland cement mortar, which had been used on the structure in the 1930s, was removed and replaced with lime mortar. At the same time, the parapet was waterproofed to prevent further water entering the structure. In September 2018, corrosion on the lion sculptures caused the tail of one of them to fall off. Clearly see the Ventura cruise ship now, behind the Queen Victoria. And there is now a line to shore. Inching ever closer. City cruise terminal is designed to accommodate the larger ships visiting the UK, Southampton's. City cruise terminal is one of the busiest. For those arriving in Southampton, there's an arrivals lounge with comfortable seating. It looks like the Queen Victoria has docked. The Svitzer Bargate tide is release the tension. Svitzer Bargate is. Reverse it to the crematorium. No, it's just like. Taking up its rope and being ready to depart. Safely in the knowledge that a cruise ship will park. Until next time, shipmates.